my favorite things. We're playing with electricity. Come on. This is electricity. Ha! But look. Ah, even here. Ah. Now usually when I had the group hanging around and I'd do this, I'd offer it to them. And for some reason, they wouldn't put it on their tongue. And I'd ask them, are you afraid of electricity, boy? They say, hell yeah, I'm afraid of electricity, or that spit you got there. Look, this is 12 volts. 12 volts is nothing. It's kind of like this one. Who's done this? Who's done this? A little tingle. 12 volts will not electrify you. I'm gonna prove that to you so you get more comfortable working with battery voltage. 12 volts is nothing. Here, you wanna talk about some voltage? Aquí. 1,000 volts. Here we go, 1,000. This is electronic fly swatter. And for some reason, I've got my students convinced that I like getting electrocuted. I wonder why they think that. Shit! I don't know why they seem to think that I like getting electrocuted. After a while, you get used to it. Like, watch this. After a while, you get used to being electrocuted. And if you go real slow, it makes it worse. Huh? Let me do it again. This is 1,000 volts, and I don't even flinch anymore. I wonder if I'll put my tongue up to it. 1,000 volts, yeah, that burns a little bit, and let me take you to 30,000 volts. Let me give you a walk around first. This is a Sun 504 distributor tester. You see them lightning bolts there? I'm gonna turn this on. This is from the 60s, maybe even the 50s. Right now, I've got a General Motors HEI. HEI stands for High Energy Ignition System. This is one of the earlier ones, but boy, you're going to see it's going to put out some spark. 30,000 volts easy. Okay, folks, here we are. Are you ready? I'm not. Check this out. See that? You hear that? That's 30,000 volts. Anyway, let's go to the hood, my favorite place. The hood. Come on, folks, right over here. There it is. The battery. There's the battery. And look, right, you're not going to get electrocuted. 12 volts is nothing. But, I forgot to show you. 12 volts will hurt you. It'll hurt you in an instant. Let me show you how 12 volts will hurt you. It's not going to electrocute you, but it will burn you in half a second. Watch this little copper wire turn red and melt. Now, I want this to work real good. I would never hold this because look at it. Watch what happens with 12 volts. How long did that take? How long did that take to get hot? A fraction of a second. What I'm trying to get to you is 12 volts is not going to electrocute you. But if you don't know what you're doing and you start jumping circuits, and if you're not careful, it's going to burn you. You know, it's kind of an initiation for my students. Well, somebody's going to have to get burned. Who's going to take it? Anyway, let's get busy over here. We already decided 12 volts is nothing. Okay, I guess I could make it if you want me to. it would tingle just a tiny little bit. But we're going to start off with one of the most important measurements. It's called open circuit voltage. Open circuit voltage. This is such a critical test. It's such an easy test. Harbor Freight. For a little while, they were free. They were giving them away with the coupon, and if you waited for the right time, these are about $10 or $12, and they're great. They're accurate. You can do quite a few things with it, and we're going to start off with some very basics, and then we'll go to intermediate. Thank you, folks, okay? What am I doing? I'm going to measure battery voltage, but I'm going to do it in a very particular way, okay? It's color-coded, and the markings are there on the battery. The positive and the negative are marked. If you look close enough, I bet you can see that positive. There's the positive. So the red one's going to go there. And sure enough, over on the other side is the negative. And yes, that's the best way. Do not go with the colors. Do not go with the size. Go with the labeling. So red to positive and black to negative. Now, when I connect, I tell the guys, the students, to dig in. Dig in means go ahead and scratch the surface. Okay, now right here, there it is. There's my reading. Okay, the perfect reading is 12.6 or better. Here we have 12.8 and a half. This is an excellent, excellent reading. Now there's a few details when you do this. The details is everything has to be turned off. Let me show you what happens if you leave a door open or a light on. Right now, that voltage is perfect. We want a 12.6 or better. Okay, you can make a mistake taking the measurement if you don't turn everything off. Let's take a look at the meter. I'm gonna open the door, I'm gonna turn on a light, and you should see that the voltage starts to drop. And the voltage is dropping. And in here, in about 2 seconds, it's going to be unacceptable. It will be less than 12.6. Okay? This is the wrong way to measure open circuit voltage. Let's finish this so we can go on. And I'm gonna go ahead and turn off the lights and close the door. Okay? Let's talk about this perfect number, 12.6. There's no reason that your vehicle shouldn't pass this test. If you don't have at least 12.6 or better, something's wrong. Well, it could be you're doing it wrong. Everything has to be turned off. And some of these are so sensitive, you actually have to have the fob away from the vehicle. No, don't put the key in there. Doors closed, lights out. You wait till all the courtesy lights turn off. Then you take your measurement. When you have that 12.6 voltage, everything is good. Battery's good. There's no parasitic draw. The charging system is good. There's no electrical short. Everything is good. But if you don't have 12.6, something's wrong. Okay? Ask me in the comments. Ask me for more information. Okay, let's go on. I tell my students, right, there's a lot not to like, this electrical. But I hope you're not afraid of 12 volts, but be careful when you start jumping. When you start jumping and you're not sure what to jump, you'll smoke that wire. There's so many things not to like, right? The diagrams, the symbols, the wires, the circuits, the wizardry that takes place with the electronics. But the most undesirable part about electrical diagnosis is you have to think. Okay, are we in trouble, folks? You have to think. You have to think, well, how does this circuit work? When does it get positive? When does it get negative? There's so much variation that takes place. Folks, I hope I got your interest going. You know, I hope you keep coming back. And I hope you learned a little bit. And I'm pretty sure, let's see how the responses go. I'm pretty sure I'm going to give you some more electrical. Oh, that's my specialty. I've taught it for 40 plus years. I think I do a pretty okay job. Let me know in the comments, please. let me know if you're interested in learning some more basics, intermediates, and possibly advanced electrical diagnostic testing. Thank you for sticking around. I hope you learned something. I hope you keep coming back. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please give us a shot. Thank you, folks.